guys, and welcome back to The Aspiring Home Cook. Today's video is all about this beautiful layered dessert with my made from scratch custard and a fruit salad jelly, and layered they both taste absolutely amazing. Now, a lot of times people think that making custard from scratch is really complicated, but I'm here to tell you that it is super simple to make. And you get a beautiful, luscious, velvety custard without any preservatives or any of that nasty stuff that you find in the packaged powders. To make the custard, here's what you're going to need. 4 egg yolks, 3 cups of milk. This is full fat, full cream milk. 1/4 cup of sugar, 1 tablespoon of cornflour, and you're going to use just a tiny pinch of salt. I've just got a little salt on there. Obviously, you're not going to use this much, just about that much salt to season the custard. I'm also going to use some vanilla bean paste. Now, if you don't have vanilla bean paste, you can also use vanilla extract, whatever you have on hand. All right, so it's really simple from here on. To make the custard, I'm just going to use a heavy bottom pan. This is just a stainless steel pan, which is nice and heavy, and you're going to need a whisk. From time to time, while the custard's cooking, you'll see me switch from a whisk to a spoon, but that's all that you'll be needing. Now, into the pan, I'm going to start by tipping in the 4 egg yolks and the sugar. I'm also going to add just a tiny pinch of salt and a teaspoon of vanilla. I'm going to start off by whisking this until it's nice and creamy. So I've got all of that whisked together, like you can see here. I'm just going to add in the cornflour and mix that through a little. Lastly, I'm going to put in the milk. That's 2 cups of milk and another 1 cup to make 3 cups of milk, and give this one good whisk to mix everything together. Now, it's a little frothy in there, so you can't really see, but everything has mixed through really well. There's no fragments of egg or anything in the pot. So once you've reached this stage, you're ready to take the pot onto your stovetop. You're going to place your custard over medium heat and bring this to a boil, stirring constantly. At this point, I'm using a whisk just to make sure that everything stays nice, velvety smooth, and without any lumps. So what I've done here is I've got my custard on medium heat, and I'm going to bring this to a boil, whisking continuously. I'm going to use a whisk because I don't want any lumps forming in there. You can also use a spoon from time to time to scrape down the sides of the vessel, but you don't want to leave this unattended. You've got to keep stirring this constantly. The entire process approximately takes about 15 minutes. I'll show you what it looks like at regular time intervals. Just bear in mind that you need to go by the look and the feel of the custard. I'll show you how to test for when it's done. Time really is relative because it depends on the thickness of your pot, as well as your ambient temperature and how high you've got your heat set. It's been 5 minutes since I put the custard onto the stove, and I'm quickly going to show you what it looks like. You can see it's still relatively very fluid and nowhere near done, but it has warmed up and it has started looking a little thick. At this point, watch carefully. Starting from here about now, try and be attentive to your custard. I'm going to continue whisking and I'll see you again in another 5 minutes. It's been about 3 minutes since I last showed you the custard. It has now started boiling, and I'm going to continue whisking this. If you feel that the level of milk is rising too rapidly, simply take your pot off the heat, continue whisking till that level of milk drops, and you can place it back on the heat after. It's all about managing the heat under the pot. A quick look can show you that this has started thickening. I'm going to keep going because I want it a little thicker than this. You can now see the difference. It's been about 10 minutes and it's a nice, thick, luscious mix. We're now going to check and see if that custard is done. I'm going to switch out to my wooden spoon. Give it a good stir. It's been about 15 minutes since I started cooking the custard off now on medium heat. And I'm going to show you. It's nice and thick. You can see that it's clinging onto that spoon a little easier now. keep stirring. You don't want to leave that unattended for too long. And you're going to check the back of the spoon. You can see that the custard coats it. Run your finger carefully. And if it leaves a track mark like this without coming back together, you know your custard is ready. I'm just going to give it another minute or so, and I'm going to take it off the heat. Okay, that's it. My custard is ready. I'm going to turn the heat off and take it off the heat. Continue stirring for a little bit, because the residual heat of the pan will continue cooking that custard for a tiny bit. Now, like you can see here, the custard is nice and smooth. There are no fragments, there's no curdling, there's nothing going on in there. It's a smooth, velvety custard speckled with those vanilla beans, and that's what I like about using that vanilla extract. From here on, you can just turn this out into a glass bowl. I'm going to do something a little different today. I'm going to actually make individual dessert portions. I've got little glasses like this, dessert glasses, and I've set them in a muffin tray, like you can see here, with just a little bit of kitchen paper to hold them at that angle. And at this angle, I'm going to try, I don't know how successful I'm going to be, but I'm going to try and pour some of that custard in at that angle. I'm going to let it set just like that, and we're going to then add on to it and make it a little fancy. And I'm gently going to move this to the back of the counter and leave that to cool down and set. Now the rest of my custard, I'm just going to put into a regular container that I can then cover with a lid. And like you can see here, right till the bottom, it's a pretty clear, creamy consistency. Now, a lot of people get concerned about a skin forming over the top. If you're one of those people, just use some cling film. Let that cling film come down in contact with the top of that custard and let it continue to cool and set. We actually happen to enjoy that skin. I know you might find it weird, but I'm going to leave it just like that, and it saves on using extra plastic. I'm just going to leave this aside to set now. Once this has come to room temperature, you can put a lid on and put your container into the fridge to cool down. Well, my custard has now set. It has come to room temperature and cooled down, and I'm now ready to add my next layer. Now, to make the jelly today, while I have used a made-from-scratch jelly before, to make it easier, I'm just going to use a store-bought jelly mix like this. I'm going to use a raspberry-flavored one. You can use raspberry or strawberry, or pretty much whatever flavor you'd like. We've always used a raspberry or a strawberry for our jelly for this particular dessert, and I'm going to continue using that today. So into a saucepan, I'm going to put those jelly granules. And from here on, just follow the directions on your packet of jelly. For me, I needed to add 1 cup of boiling water. That's 250 milliliters. And you're going to stir it well to make sure all of those granules and crystals have thoroughly dissolved. Once it has completely dissolved, I'm going to add 200 milliliters of cold water and stir that to mix it through the solution. Now again, different brands may recommend different quantities of water, so please follow the package instructions on the jelly packet that you're using. While that jelly cools down, let's talk fruit. Over here, I've got mandarins. You can use oranges or whatever citrus, sweet citrus fruit you've got available. Now, if you don't have citrus, that's fine. You can use a variety of fruits here. Just make sure you're not using pineapple, kiwi fruit, or papaya. These three fruits will prevent the jelly from setting. But apart from that, I've used berries, I've used grapes, and like you can see here, I'm also going to add in a little bit of chopped apple and banana. So go ahead and experiment with the variety of fruits that are in season wherever you are, and chop them up into little pieces before you can add them to the jelly. Now, you need to make sure your jelly is at room temperature before you add the fruit to it. Otherwise, your fruit's going to cook in there. And I'm going to give it one good stir to more or less mix up all the fruit that's in there. Now, if you're making
a layered dessert like me, all that's left is to add the jelly into your containers or serving bowls. Just make sure you get a good percentage of jelly and fruit in there, and that you get an assortment of fruit in there as well. And I'm now just going to leave those bowls aside. You're going to set them on a flat level surface, and you're going to refrigerate them and let them set completely. And if you're not making individual portions, you can just pour this into a large bowl and leave it to set and serve later. Now my jelly and custard have both had time to cool down and set. You can see the jelly's got a beautiful jiggle and has set well. This has been chilling in the fridge overnight. That's what makes this dessert perfect for a gathering or a party. You can actually prepare this a day ahead and have it ready to serve for your party. Now have a look at these individual portions. Don't they look absolutely gorgeous? There's a little bit of effort that went into making that custard from scratch. Not too much though, but the end result is absolutely stunning. And if you have a whole bunch of these little containers set out, they definitely make a stunning addition to your next party. So I really hope you enjoyed today's easy, simple, yet stunning and delicious dessert recipe. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and share it with family and friends that you think might like it too. And if you're new here, please subscribe to my channel. Once you do that, don't forget to click that little bell icon right next to it so that you get notified every time a new video gets uploaded. As always, I'm going to leave a link to the complete recipe down in the description box below just for you. Thank you so much for watching today, guys. I'm going to see you really soon with another delicious recipe. So till then, take care. Bye.